Silverton Audio presents the unabridged recording of 0200 Hours, a fact-based military thriller. Written by Eric Wentz. Narrated by Brian Callanan. The Prologue. Arabian Desert, AD 605. Like a dervish in a dance, death descended out of the darkness of the desert, and raiders whirled on their camels and horses, striking the encampment. The Bedouin tents flapped and fell upon the slaughtered like shrouds. One man dropped to the sand, headless before his tent, as his wife screamed in childbirth and her own death. Hours later, one rider in the moonless night held the newborn in swaddling clothes as he converged on the tented caravan. As he dismounted, he asked of the man who greeted him, "Kadisha?
Her labors are greater than yours or mine. What is this?"
Then he paused as he looked at the sleeping child beneath the coverlet in the glow of the flickering torch.
"The child will not live."
Before he could respond, a scream rang out from a tent. They entered. In the tent and torchlight, in her pain and delirium, a woman reached for her stillborn child and forcefully grabbed at the placenta as the midwife futilely sought to wrench it from her hand.
"I knew it was a boy," she moaned.
"It is a girl,"
whispered the midwife, as the mother cradled the stillborn and smeared its head with the placenta.
"How like his father,"
she moaned, and fell backward in sleep as the midwife cleaned her and took away the child. As she slept, Muhammad, hidden in the shadow with Abu Bakr, put the sleeping child to her breast. The midwife looked away, pretending not to see. The two men walked outside, where camels nibbled on a boxwood tree and the horses nuzzled one another in the near total darkness. The raiders piled their loot at Muhammad's tent.
"I would not expect this," uttered Muhammad. "This child will bring trouble."
"Not for you. No one saw me take it. She is your legacy."
"Yes, and now the relic of a vanquished tribe."
Chapter 1. The Prophecy of the Scepter and the Moon. The secrets of empires do not vanish with their collapse. They sustain them. Momoa Christophorn. Constantinople, Tuesday, May 29th, 1453, the year 6961 of the Byzantine calendar. Father Marcellus Popandro, the last man ever to celebrate the liturgy in the great church, looked out over the city from the exterior of its great dome that circled the church like a crown. Within the alcove of the dome, his black robe blended with shadows. With the even temper of a saint, he sat patiently as the frenetic world around him burned off its zealotry in rape, rapine, looting, and fire. Beneath the overcast sky, the destitute multitudes in the streets far below flung themselves at and on one another. In the distance, he spied a solitary white horse straining to advance through the crowds. As horse and rider closed on the church, Father Marcellus, his green eyes wet with grief at the city's fall, receded from view into the masonry's hidden opening. The pale rider on a white horse, like a solar eclipse, showed the pallor of his being to the dead and dying. Serene in his lunar-like ellipse, he migrated the earthly dominion of the last of the Caesars, whose pagan emblem of 2,000 years seemed to have melted away in an Icarian display of stupidity and hubris, the two-headed eagle. In a slowly shrinking gyre, horse and rider moved on as he imagined the very stones beneath him in wave-like undulations of the sea, pulled loose by his very presence. In a world that, to many, would seem to be upside down and a precursor to the apocalypse itself, he was drawn by the ripples of the silent surge of history and the gravity of a destiny that pulled him to the center of Greek and Roman spirituality.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.